I'm 26, making a good salary, but my relationship is starting to feel more like a financial burden than a partnership. Here's why I think my fiancé sees me as her family's ATM. I'm 26, earning a high salary that puts me in a completely different financial bracket than my fiancé, who's 24. We've been together for 3 years and engaged for a few months, but her constant financial demands are really testing my limits. A few days ago, her cousin had a medical emergency and needed a large sum for hospital bills. It was a significant amount, one I couldn't ignore. I told my fiancé that I simply couldn't pay it. She went off on me, calling me selfish and saying if I truly loved her, I'd help her family. Her mom even sent me a text saying I was wrong for not stepping up, and it didn't end there. Just a few days later, her uncle, who I've never even met, reached out and asked me for a loan to fund a business idea. He made it sound urgent, and of course, my fiancé was right there, nodding like it was no big deal. I said no, and once again, my fiancé guilt-tripped me, saying, "This is how my family survives, why can't you just help?" It's a pattern now, whether it's paying for vacations, covering hospital bills, or funding business ventures, I'm always expected to foot the bill. I'm starting to feel like I'm just a walking ATM, not a partner. My fiancé, who comes from a lower income background, expects me to cover her family's bills and emergencies, even though I make a lot more. After her uncle asked for a loan, I'm wondering if this is getting out of hand. Update 1. So after the whole uncle thing, I realized I was getting pushed to my limit. Like, this wasn't even about money anymore. It was about feeling like I wasn't a person in this relationship, just a wallet. I decided to sit down with her and talk about it, and let me tell you, that went interestingly. I started by saying something like, "Hey, I need to talk about how I've been feeling lately." She immediately got defensive, like, "Oh, here we go, you're gonna say I don't appreciate you or something." I hadn't even gotten to the point yet. I stayed calm, though, and explained how her family's constant financial asks were making me feel. I said it wasn't just about the money, it was about the fact that it didn't seem like she understood how stressful this was for me. She hit me with, "Well, you knew my family wasn't well off when we got together, so what's the big deal now?" That made me pause. Like, yeah, I knew she came from a different background, but I didn't think being with her meant I was signing up to support her entire family forever. I tried to explain that I want to help when I can, but there has to be a limit. She said, "If we're gonna get married, my family is your family, so why wouldn't you help?" At this point, I was trying really hard not to lose it. I told her that I want to be there for her and even help her family when it's reasonable. But this wasn't reasonable. Her cousin's medical bills, her uncle's business idea, random vacations her mom wanted to plan, all of it was adding up. I said, "I can't be the only one giving in this relationship. It feels like I'm just a bank to you." That's when she started crying. Not the kind of cry that makes you feel bad, though. More like the kind that feels manipulative. She said, "I thought you loved me. If you really loved me, this wouldn't even be a conversation." That hit me hard because it's like, what does love even mean to her? Does she think love is just throwing money at her family whenever they ask? Then she hit me with something that honestly shook me. She said, "If you can't handle my family, maybe we shouldn't get married." I didn't even know what to say. I just sat there, stunned, because I felt like she was giving me an ultimatum. Either I fully accept being a financial provider for her whole family, or I lose her. I told her I needed time to think about all this, and she stormed off. A few hours later, I got a text from her mom. It was like a freaking essay, basically saying I was selfish, that I didn't understand what it meant to be in a real partnership, and that I should do better if I want to keep her daughter. She also threw in a line about how their family has sacrificed so much for each other, and I need to step up if I want to be part of that. At this point, I was just tired. It's like, how am I the bad guy for not wanting to fund someone's business or pay for vacations I'm not even going on? I started wondering if this is how it's always going to be. Like, If we get married, will it just be endless demands from her family forever? The next day, her uncle called me. I don't even know how he got my number, but he called and started pitching me his business idea again. He kept saying stuff like, "This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity," and, "I just need a little help to get started." I told him no again, and he had the audacity to say, "Well, I thought you were serious about being part of this family." That was the moment I realized this isn't just about her. Her whole family sees me as a piggy bank. It's like they're not even trying to hide it anymore. I blocked her uncle's number right after that because I couldn't deal with it. When I told my fiancé about the call, she got mad at me for blocking him. She said, "That's so disrespectful. You can't just ignore my family like that." I told her, "Your family is ignoring my boundaries, so what am I supposed to do?" She said, "You're supposed to support me, not make things harder." I don't even know what to do at this point. I love her, but this is becoming too much. It's not just the money, it's the constant guilt tripping, the feeling that no matter how much I give, it'll never be enough. I'm starting to think maybe we're just too different, like our views on family and money are so far apart that we can't make this work. But then I wonder, am I being selfish? Like, maybe I'm just not used to how her family operates and I need to adjust. Or maybe this is a giant red flag, and I'm ignoring it because I don't want to admit I made a mistake by proposing. I don't know. All I know is, something has to change because I can't keep living like this. Update 2. So, after the whole mess with her uncle calling me, I started thinking harder about the situation. I didn't want to make a rash decision, but at the same time, it felt like everything was pointing to one conclusion. My fiancé and I needed to have another serious conversation because, honestly, I couldn't keep brushing this off like it would fix itself. A couple of days later, I brought it up again. She was already acting distant, which didn't surprise me. I told her we needed to set boundaries with her family. Like, real ones. I said something like, "I love you, but I feel like your family's expectations are taking over our relationship. If we're going to work, we have to figure this out together." Her reaction? She rolled her eyes and said, "You're making this way bigger than it is. My family just needs help sometimes, and you're acting like it's a crime to ask you for it." I told her, "It's not about helping sometimes. It's about how it's become constant and one-sided." She fired back with, "You're just not used to what it means to be part of a family like mine." That hit a nerve. I told her, "Being part of a family doesn't mean being taken advantage of. If they cared about us as a couple, they wouldn't be putting this much pressure on you or me." She looked at me like I had just insulted her entire existence. She got quiet for a minute and then said, "Okay, what do you want me to do? Stop talking to my family? Tell them to never ask for anything again? That's not realistic." I tried explaining that it wasn't about cutting them off. It was about finding a balance where we could help when it was reasonable without them treating me like a bank. She still didn't get it, though. Then, out of nowhere, she said, "You know what? Maybe we rushed into this engagement." That threw me off. I asked her what she meant, and she said, "I just don't think you understand my life, my family, or what I need in a partner." I was stunned. Like, was she actually saying this right now? I asked her if she was having second thoughts about marrying me. She said, "I'm just saying, if you can't handle this, maybe we're not meant to be together." That hit me hard. I told her, "I want to be with you, but I can't marry you if this is how it's going to be. Marriage is supposed to be a partnership, not a one-way street where I'm the only one giving." She didn't respond for a while, and the silence was brutal. Then she said, "I need time to think about this." We didn't talk much for the next few days. She was staying at her mom's house, which honestly gave me some space to figure out what I wanted. During that time, I started thinking about what life would look like if we got married. Would I ever feel like an equal partner? Or would it always feel like I was being taken for granted? Then, something weird happened. Her cousin, the one with the medical bills, texted me. I hadn't even given her my number, so I have no idea how she got it. She thanked me for always being there for their family, and then casually mentioned that her mom might reach out soon because she needed help with something, too. That was my breaking point. I didn't even reply. I just blocked her number. When my fiancé came back a few days later, I told her what happened. Her response? Well, she probably thought you'd understand since you helped with the medical bills. That made me snap a little. I told her, that's exactly the problem. Your family assumes I'll just handle everything, and you don't do anything to stop it. She started crying again, but this time I wasn't falling for it. I told her, I can't keep doing this. If you can't see how unhealthy this is, I don't think we can move forward. That's when she hit me with the wildest thing yet. She said, honestly, I thought you'd get over this by now. I've been talking to my mom, and she thinks you're not ready for marriage because you're too focused on money. I couldn't believe it. I asked her, do you even want to marry me, or do you just want someone to take care of your family? She didn't answer right away, but when she finally did, she said, I want both. That was it for me. I told her I needed time to think and asked her to stay at her mom's place for a while. I'm still trying to process everything, but one thing is clear. This isn't just about money. It's about respect, boundaries, and whether we're actually compatible. Right now, I'm leaning toward ending things, but it's not an easy decision. I still love her, but I don't think love is enough to fix something this broken.